Hello everybody and good day. This is Fred with Tech Talk and I'm coming at you today with a video on what you can do if you have a older analog DVR and you want to upgrade your cameras to IP cameras, right? Today's IP cameras are much more advanced than the older analog cameras. They now have AI or artificial intelligence and smart motion detection where they can actually detect a person or a vehicle. And they will only record or send motion alerts if it's one of those two things. Back in the day, the older analog cameras, even the analog high-definition cameras, they would send motion alerts and trigger recording for, you know, trees blowing in the wind. Up here in the north, we have snowstorms. We have heavy rainstorms. They would set it off. We have some in marina locations where if the waves were big enough, you know, the motion alerts would be sent off. So those types of environments would obviously want the smarter IP cameras, okay? And when you do that, most people think you need to buy a NVR, a network video recorders, that's actually set up for IP cameras, and that's actually not the case. What we have here, if you look at a screen, we have a typical Hikvision Turbo DVR. And on the back of the DVR, you will see audio in for four cameras. Okay, there are BNC connectors for four cameras. You see them right here, 1, 2, 3, 4. What we would do in the event we want to transition this DVR to a NVR, we would unplug these analog cameras. Okay, we'd unplug the BNC connectors so it would look something like this. And we would install at that location the four IP cameras. Okay, the four IP cameras would then hook to a PoE switch. Which gets plugged into the LAN of this DVR, as well as the facility's internet, which could be a modem or router. It's not a difficult process. We're going to cover it all right now. All right, so what do you say? Let's get into the meat and potatoes. Before we do, you know the drill. There is a subscribe button in the bottom right-hand corner of your screen. Please click that and subscribe to our channel if you have not yet done so. That way you'll be notified when we upload future content. Also like the video if it's useful to you. And as always, leave comments. A lot of these videos are based on subscriber and or viewer comments. Okay, so we'd appreciate that. So yes, as discussed, we have disconnected the four analog BNC connectors for the analog cameras. And we have installed four IP cameras. Okay. You will see the IP cameras have a an Ethernet plug on the end of the pigtail, and those would be hardwired using Cat 5 or 6 cable directly to one of the PoE ports on the PoE switch, okay? The DVR would also be plugged into one of those PoE ports, okay? On a PoE switch, the PoE ports can be used for both power over Ethernet, PoE devices, and normal LAN devices. So even though the NVR, the LAN port in the NVR does not need PoE, it can still be connected to the internet through this PoE switch, okay? So we have the modem or router connected to the uplink port, the cameras connected to the PoE switch, and the DVR connected to the PoE switch. Obviously, if we wanted to install the maximum of four cameras at this location, we would actually need a 8-port PoE switch, right? Because one of the ports would have to be used for the DVR. And right now we only have 3 available for the cameras, okay? So remember that if you want to use all 4 cameras, you need a 4-port PoE switch, okay? So what we're going to do, we're going to set this up as described and depicted in this video. And then we are going to log in to a DVR and teach you how to switch that DVR out of analog mode into NVR mode and how to add 4 IP cameras to a 4-channel DVR. It's a relatively simple process. We're going to cover it right now. All right, the first thing we are going to do is pull up our DVR. I'm using a browser to do so. If you had the DVR connected to a monitor, you could go through this same process. But what we're going to do is we're going to disable the analog functions of the DVR and enable the IP functions, converting this digital video recorder, the DVR, to an IP NVR, a network video recorder. You'll see the analog cameras listed here. We have unplugged each of those. So if you were to click on one of these cameras, you'll see no video. Okay. The first thing we're going to do is go to the configuration tab up on the top of the toolbar here. And when we click that, we want to go to the system tab. Okay. Right here on the left toolbar, there is a system tab. And one of your options are going to be camera management. Okay. We want to click on camera management. And as you will see, the analog camera functions are enabled. Okay. We want to click this box and disable the analog cameras, which will enable us to add the full complement of four IP cameras, right? This is a four-channel DVR, and we want to convert it to a four-channel NVR using the IP protocol settings. So again, we're going to disable the check marks. We're going to hit save here. When we do that, the DVR is going to reboot and come back online as a NVR, and we'll add those IP cameras. So let's go ahead and hit save. And we should see a prompt that tells us it's rebooting. There it is. We'll let it finish that process. All right, it looks like our DVR has rebooted. We'll go ahead and log into the recorder. And as you can see now, the analog cameras are now all unchecked. So we can switch over to the IP camera tab, and we can now manually add each of our IP cameras. When they were installed, I used the SADP tool that Geekvision has to activate each of the cameras and to give them an IP address. Okay. If you are unfamiliar with that process, there is a link going across the top of your screen right now that will walk you through how to activate the IP camera and give it a IP address on the network. Okay. Obviously, for this to work, your NVR and the IP cameras will have to be on the same network. Okay. We are using Comcast. So if I go to my network tab, this DVR, when it was installed, was in DHCP mode. And when you do that and reboot the DVR, the routing device on your network is going to give the DVR an IP address on your network, okay, on your LAN. And for Comcast, again, that's 10.1.10.1. So our cameras are also on that 10.1.10.1 gateway, okay. Our cameras are 10.1.10.100, 101, 102, and 103. Okay. So with that said, we'll go back into the camera settings and we will add our IP cameras. Okay. And to do that, we're just going to hit add. We're going to enter the IP address of each camera. They are Geekvision cameras. If they were another brand, we would pick the ONVIF protocol, okay? And all that does is switch the management port to port 80, which ONVIF uses, okay? Geekvision is going to use 8000. It's always a good idea, if you've watched my previous videos, to use like equipment. In other words, if you have a Geekvision NVR or DVR, we want a Geekvision IP cameras, right? So let me put in the password for these. And they should switch here where it says status from offline to online. That does take a second, so I'll go ahead and add the second camera. And the last one. And again, these passwords are simply the passwords that you created when you activated the cameras using the SADP tool. Okay. As you can see, the first three have gone online. We're waiting for the fourth to go online. But what we can do is we can go to Live View. Okay, we're in the configuration tab. If we go over to Live View, we should be able to see each of these cameras. Okay, they'll come up here on the directory to the left. We also named the cameras using the SADP tool, so it looks like the DVR imported the names. So essentially, we're just going to click on each one. There's camera 2, 3, 4. We can switch our window pane to the 4-window screen. But as you can see, here are four megapixel IP cameras streaming at full resolution and frame rate using a DVR. Okay, you see the people walking. There doesn't appear to be any lag. You see vehicles moving in the background. It is a relatively simple process, and we just saved ourselves the money of a new NVR, right? A lot of these IP cameras, they will have micro SD slots, okay? The problem with those slots is you can only go up to, with some model cameras, 128 gigabytes, and with others, 256. But in a location like this where there's a lot of movement, those cards are going to fill up rather quickly. And in these DVRs, you know, you could put 2 6-terabyte hard drives. And get many, many, at least several months worth of video storage with those hard drives. That's the advantage of using a DVR, converting it to an NVR, is we can use those hard drives and get large amounts of data recorded, whereas the micro SD cards, they're not going to give us so long. Okay. But like I said, you can see people walking. There's no freezing. It works just fine. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. We'll see you in the field.